Cellini Sardini. Madame Sardini will attempt. Will attempt, ladies and gentlemen, a high flying leap from point A to point B. Give her a big hand, Cellini.
Until I see my net. So where's it at? was each one's duty to take care of and work with their own personal net. But there were consequences. Aunt Rosa hit the outside edge of her net and bounced off. And just moments earlier, she had been threatening to replace it. You don't want an uptight net! My father, oh, he took very good care of his net. Until one night, he got so wrapped up in his ability to fly higher than the rest of us that he got to going so fast that he flew up over the top of his net and landed Mare Centibelis from the crowd. And poor Aunt Madarina, oh, she was so attached to her net that she got stuck in it. Her neck in her net. Oh, you could say it's a hazard of the business. Some business. It has taken its toll on the family. And now, what with accidents, death, and old age, it's up to me to carry on the tradition. The death-defying, leaping, jumping Sardini tradition. It's up to me, Cellini, baby Sardini. But I ain't gonna do it without my net. So why am I here talking to you when I should already made my leap and been out of here? Where is that overgrown lace curtain? I'm screaming! Where is it? Where's the net? Don't tell me it doesn't matter. Where's the net? I will not fly without it. I will not fly. I will not jump. I will not let go. I will not trust until I see my net. So where's that? It made sure I talk about it day in, day out. Three flights a day. So what if the poster shows me a couple of years ago? I'm well preserved, I'm not pate, I'm gonna stay this way. Give me my net. It may be full of holes, but I like it that way. Maybe torn and tattered. Don't tell me that it doesn't matter. Where's the net? I will not fly without it.
No clowns. This is a circus!
to center ring. Clown to center ring. Cellini Sardini, who had perfected for the first time the death-defying leap between point A and point B. 13 years old I was. And now what? At the age of close to half a century, and I'm not telling you which half, I am fired.
might shoot me instead. Get the whole thing over with. If I cannot do my job, what am I supposed to do? What am I good for? Am I good for nothing? I'm no good to myself. And what about my family? Oh, dead or not, I'm no good to them now. And what do I do when people ask me what I do? What do I say? Do I actually say nothing? Well, what would they think? What will I think? Somebody's bound to think something. And what about the money? No job means no money. No money means no room, no board, no bursitis medicine, no costumes. Solid. There's no beginning, no middle, no end, niet, 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 nix. Not. Oh. Oh. Blackness. Aloneness. Nothingness. Blackness. Aloneness. Whoa, Cellini, take a load off. Oh.
bambina, step right up. A showtime.
Daddy! No, no, Daddy!
Nose, if you please. Closer. Closer.
Oh, Vanetta, you're a funny lady.
That's what they pay me for, kiddo. Come, Chili. You tell me a story. A funny, funny, funny story.
Ladies and gentlemen, we interrupt tonight's Rapid Eye Movement Dreamtime program to bring you a message from the Safety Institute of North America. Founded on our dependency, supported by our safekeeping, forever long standing on our persistent foundation, we of the Safety Institute of North America would like to welcome you to the Safety Zone, a weekly program to enable you to raise your level of safety. We here at the Safety Zone would like to remind you to
play it safe, leave your soul uncovered.
Is Hackford Dorman.
exhilarate your safety vest. To lift, to right, this way, that way, around the back, back again. So, oh, oh, yes, oh. So, henceforth, bullies are there. There, here, here. Good. Crotchet number three.
Thank you.
job, a new way. I'm too old to change, I'm endangered. A new life, a new day. I'm a stranger in a strange land. I feel the danger. Can you teach new tricks to an old dog like me? I'm no chicken of the springtime. Can you haul this tuna from the sea? A new job, a new way. What would my family do? What would my family say? How could you? And at your age, how could I? I suppose I could try. You know, when I was a kid, there never was any question what I was going to be when I grew up. No Sardini child would even think to ask that question. Or what other job in the circus would a flying Sardini think of doing anyway? It's a good thing I wasn't born with a defective inner ear. New job? Different kind of job? Maybe. When I was a kid, I had fantasies about being somebody else. A great artist. No, not a picture. And I'm not talking about an artistic death-defying leaper either. I was... You listening? I am embarrassed to tell you what it was. I'm afraid you're going to laugh at me. It was a fantasy. It was a kid's fantasy. But it was real. I wanted be a great, like Buffonetta. She was a world famous red nose. She was on Ed Sullivan. I mentioned it to my family. They laughed, patted me on the head. No room for a As long as I was part of the flying family, I was part of it, net and all. I still dream about it. But it's too late for me. Not in this lifetime. I'm too old. Besides, who'd hire me? There's rarely any openings. And it does take a very special gifted person, a great artist with many years of training and performing. I should know, as a professional death-defying leaper, I have been working for 50 years on my craft. There'd be a lot more people better qualified than me. I wouldn't be very funny. Nobody'd laugh. Not the way they laughed for Buffonetta. Buffonetta. I mean shawarma, all at once, layers and layers. She looked huge. And she always wore on her hat a tiny pointed hat with three big buttons. Green, yellow, and blue. I'll never forget those buttons. And sometimes Buffonetto, she would come out and she would play with a pet monkey. And at the end of the whole show, she'd come out and she'd dance. She was not your conventional dancer. A ballet company wouldn't want her. And you'd think twice about asking her dancing on a Saturday night. You might say Buffonetta was a little awkward. Well, honestly, she did have two left feet. But dance she did. And the joy she brought. Buffonetta danced and danced. And the people laughed and laughed. And from the wings, I could see, I knew what nobody else knew, that Buffonetta was laughing to herself. She was laughing on the inside the whole time. She had it all. Here I am. The only job I've ever known is over. I don't get it. I just don't get it. I can't see a future. I can't see anything. All I see is, blackness, aloneness, nothingness. The void. I'm going to sleep on it. Wait, Cellini, you had a dream. What was it? Something about a mirror. Stepping through and beyond a mirror. Oh, there's something more to it than that. Risk all. I wonder what that means. Risk all. I'm breaking with tradition. I'm breaking with the past. The ground on which I'm standing is disappearing fast. I'm breaking out in goosebumps. My heart is ringing too. To think of doing something else. To think of doing something new. A new job. A new way. I could change. I feel strange. A new life. A new day. I feel the danger. You could teach new tricks to an old dog like me. I'm no chicken of the springtime, but you could haul me from the sea. A new job, a new way. Could I? Would I?
Cellini Sardini. Attention and congratulations! Your application has been received, perused, stamped, and accepted! The management of the circus is proud to announce that you have just qualified for a legitimate, certified, accredited degree-granting and reasonably professional job training program. Upon completion, you will be required to pass an audition examination. If you pass, you will become undisputed center ring red-nosed clown.
An opportunity! Me, a red-nosed clown. A new job, a new way. It's a miracle.
Thank you.
to put everything down. I will listen for the birds. I will smile. The judges will laugh. I will count to five to myself while the judges are laughing. Right. Then I will put upon the ground my tablecloth. I will listen for the birds. I will smile. I will count to five while the judges are laughing. Then I will put on my plastic poncho. I will put up my umbrella. I will listen for the birds. I will smile. I will count to seven while the judges are laughing. Then I will put upon the ground my seat protector.
comes with parts of myself which are holding me, which I'm holding to, which keep me in bondage. The time has come to let go.
Restore the dream.
the world for the first time. It's exciting. I can't see the future. I can't see the past. I am here. Now. And I like it.
Calling all clown school trainees. Attention all circus personnel. We deem it necessary to reconvene our auditions for red-nosed clowns. Those interested, please report to center ring immediately. Welcome, auditioners. Once again, the demand for humor is rising, and the supply of clowns is lagging far behind. To be exact, we have no new clowns. The last class produced not one funny clown. Not one student reached the mark. Thus, we have rescheduled examinations. We need more clowns. Judges, please report to center ring. Student clowns, please stand by. Your names will be called. Thank you. Cellini Sardini. Cellini Sardini.
Ha 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 ha!
to me on my birth bed. My birth bed. What a long time ago that was. So much has happened since then. I've changed. You too? Annette! And you have been such a wonderful friend. You've been one special, terrific, I couldn't ask for more walk to the ends of earth kind of friend. So many times you were there to catch me. But I don't need you to catch me anymore. Maybe I never did. I